Good morning, students. This is Joy Varghese from Uncovering Chemistry. Today, in video 20, we are going to discuss about carboxylic acid. It's a whole new functional group what we have discussed till now. Clear? Your chapter, when we say unit 12, was divided into two parts. The first part was aldehyde, ketones and carboxylic acid. And the second part, what we call is our, first part was aldehyde and ketone, and second part is carboxylic acid. Okay. Now, in this carboxylic acid, today we are going to discuss about the introduction part. That is, the carbon compound, the word is what? The carbon compound containing COOH group. Now, this COOH can be written as C-O-O-N-O-H, that is, group, is called carboxylic group. Clear? The carbon compound containing functional group. FG means what? The functional group, that is COOH group, is called what we call it as the carboxylic group. Now, the carboxyl group, the name came from which word? That is a carbonyl group. This is your carbonyl group attached to a hydroxyl group. From that, the word came carboxyl. What is the word? Carboxyl group, that is carbonyl plus hydroxyl. Clear? So carbo and XYL. So like that, carboxyl group word came. That is from carbonyl and hydroxyl group. By adding these two, what we get it as a carboxyl group, what we say. Understood? So this is the thing what we are going to discuss. Now, when we talk about the common name, when we talk about the IUPAC name, most of the carboxylic groups are named, what you call, known from their common names, means from the source from where they are being derived. So when you see in your NCERT textbook regarding the first introductory part of carboxyl group, we will see that it is derived from the natural source. That is, now suppose formic acid, when we say, so formic means from the ant, formica, Greek word what we say, or Latin what we say. So formica means ant. So when the ant bites, no, the irritation is due to that acid, that what we call it as formic acid. That is a common name, and the IUPAC name for formic acid is what we call methanoic acid. Okay. So how this nomenclature is done, what is about common name, what are common names, what are IUPAC names, this all rules are there that we are going to discuss. In common name there are no rules, but only in IUPAC name there are rules what we are going to follow in the next part of our video. Okay, just a minute. Now, the higher members of what we call it is, now higher member means when we talk about, that is C12 to C18 carbons of this containing that carboxylic group, we call it as fatty acid. Okay, so if you want, you can write the definition. That is, the higher member of aliphatic carboxyl compound. That is, the higher member of aliphatic, what we call it as are called fatty acids. Which acid? Fatty acid. Now, when we talk about this higher member means what? C12 to C18. Means you will write carbon how many times? 12 times you will write, and COOH. And this is total 12 carbons like this. Understood? Just imagine. 12 carbons and 11 carbons plus one carbon of this COOH, that is a higher members. What we call it as are called fatty acids. These are very weak compounds. What we say means higher molecular mass and all such things. Okay. Now the next part. Now when we talk about the nomenclature part, there are two names what we know till now. One is common name and another is IUPAC name. For common name, there are no rules, what we say. Clear? Means from the source it is derived, from the person who has discovered like that. Okay. So now when we talk about carboxylic acid, most of them are known by its common name. That is, if you see here, formic acid. So formic acid name came from the Latin word formica. Formica means ant, what we say. Kiri, what we call in Gujarati. Okay. Then when we talk about acetic acid, it came from the word Latin word acetum. Acetum means from vinegar, understood? And when we talk about butyric acid, we get it from butyrum, means Latin word butyrum means what? Butter. Now it is obtained by rancid butter. Now what is rancidity? That is, whenever we talk about the food containing or containing oils or fat, what we say, butter and all, that food when it gets oxidized, okay, so that is called rancid. That condition by oxidation of oily food, we call it as rancidity. The condition or the phenomenon of what you call the oily food when get exposed to oxygen, it gets oxidized, and that we call it as rancidity. So from rancid butter we get this butyrum, that is what? Butyric acid. Four carbons, what we say. Okay, the higher carbons, that is C12 to C18, we call it as fatty acids. What we call it as fatty acids, what we call. Okay, so this was what about fatty acid, what I call about fatty acids, that is carbon containing C12 or C18 with a functional group, we call it as a fatty acid. Now when we talk about fatty acid, they occur in natural fats, what we say. In which fat? Natural fat has esters of glycerol. What are esters of glycerol? Okay, now glycerol, when you say, I think you must have glycerin, you must have heard about, means 3 carbon, and on that all carbon OH groups are there. Which groups are there? OH group. 3 OH groups are there, we call it as glycerol. 2 OH groups are there, we call it as what? Glycol, if you heard about. Okay. So here, if what are there, you can just balance it with the hydrogen like this. So this is the formula for glycerol or glycerin, what we call. Understood? So higher groups of fatty acid, what we call, there are more carbon atoms, what we call. Okay, so remember this thing. So this was all about fatty acid. Then common name, it is derived from the source from where we got, from the Latin word, these three examples are given. Now when we talk about IUPAC names, which names? IUPAC names, so always remember, in IUPAC name, the last letter, that is, now suppose if I write like this, CH3 C double O H, so total 1 and 2 carbons are there, right? So 2 carbon means what? What is 2 carbon means? Ethane. So the name is ethane. From ethane, E is eliminated and OIC acid is being added. In which name? I am talking about IUPAC. Understood? So the name of this compound will be ethanoic acid. Which acid? The name of the compound is ethanoic acid. So what is being replaced? Ethane E is replaced with OIC acid, and that's why we call it as ethanoic acid. And always remember, whenever you number this carboxylic groups, what we say, the carbon, if I suppose if I give an example, CH2, CH2 and C double OH. So the carbon of carboxylic group, that is the carbon of carboxylic group, must always get number 1 in IUPAC nomenclature. In which nomenclature? IUPAC nomenclature. Okay. So the name of this compound, 5 carbon means what? Pentane. From pentane, what is removed? E is removed, and what is added? OIC acid. So the name is pentanoic acid, what we call. Understood? Always give this carboxylic acid carbon number 1 in IUPAC nomenclature. Understood this part? So this was all about common name, IUPAC name. Few examples or tables are given in your textbook that I am going to discuss next. Okay? Now, in your textbook, table 12.4 I am talking about. Which table? Table 12.4, right? This table, you have to write it down in your fair book, one by one. See, in that first one, if you see, the structure is like this, what we say, the formula, what we say, structure HCOOH is given, okay. So when we say there is a common name and IUPAC name are the two columns what are given in your textbook, if you see. Common name is formic acid and IUPAC name is methanoic acid. Which acid? Methanoic acid. Clear? Now why? Because there is only one carbon. So from methane, E is being replaced and what is it? OIC acid is being added. What is added? E is being replaced and OIC
acid is added. From that methanoic acid. Second one is acetic acid that we already discussed. Third is propanoic acid. Both name are same. Fourth one is like this.
I have second, third and fourth is easy, so I am not writing that. Third one. Now the fourth one, what is given? It is given like this: CH3, CH2, CH2, COOH. So if you see, there are total, if you see, four carbon. Now for four carbon, the name here will be butanoic acid. Which acid? Butanoic acid, but common name is different. That is what? Butyric acid. Which acid it is? Butyric.
Because from butter, rancid butter, we get this. That's why butyric acid name is there. Then the next one is what we call it as?
The next structure, I think in your book it is written like this, the fifth structure, that is CH3 twice CH2, twice CH and COOH, right? So if I want to write the structure, I can write it in another way like this, that is what? CH3 C H COOH, one more CH3, I'll write it on the top. Right. So if you see the name in this case, if you see the name here, in this case, this is the iso group. So in your common name, it must be written isobutyric. What is the word given there? Isobutyric. Isobutyric acid is the name what is given there. Okay. And in another name, if I want, I can write here 1, 2 and 3. So second position, which group is there? Methyl. So the name is 2-methyl. Clear? And in a parent chain, 3 carbon are there. So 2-methyl propanoic acid. What is the name?
2-methyl propanoic acid is the name what is given. Okay? Understood this part? Now the next one. Now if you see the next structures here,
if you see here, there is total 2 carbon, but the common name for this is oxalic acid. Which acid? Oxalic acid. But when we write the IUPAC name, you will see there are two functional groups, two COOH groups are there. So the name for this will be ethane, E-T-H-A-N-E. Ethane, E is being replaced, it is not being eliminated. And di, di means two COOH groups, so di OIC acid. Clear? So this di is for two functional group, what we say, COOH group. Understood? Now in the second case, if you see, 1, 2 and 3 when we write, right?
So in this case, the name for this, what we say, is given malonic acid.
Which acid? Malonic acid. Understood? Now this you have to remember, oxalic acid, malonic acid, like this. But if you see, total 3 carbons are there. So 3 means propane it is. So it will be what? Propane, E is replaced and di OIC acid. So from that the name came.
Now what we say here, the di is for
what? Two functional group, two COOH groups what we say. Understood this part? Okay. Now
the next one what we say. In this case, if you see here,
next one, if you see total, this can be written like this, COOH and this 2 times CH2. So I will write CH2, CH2 and COOH, like this what we say. Understood this part? So in this case, if I write 1, 2, 3, 4, like this, so total 4 are there. But for here, common name, there are no rules, and for this, they have written the name succinic acid. What? Succinic acid, what we say. Understood this part? Now when we say 4 carbons are there, so it will be what? Butane. What is the word? Butane dioic acid. Butane dioic acid, what we say. Then when we talk about this here, so I will write here total how many times? 3 times I will write CH2. Then again here CH2 and COOH. So if you see 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay, so now in this case, if you see here, in this case, this is butyric acid. Which acid?
Butyric.
Butyric acid, what we say, right? So butyric acid when we say, but when you write the IUPAC name, total 5 are there. So for 5, we can write pentane, what is the word? Pentane dioic acid. pentane dioic acid. Okay,
so like this all namings are given. Then if another after this in your book it is given for 6 carbon, so that is adipic acid, and hexane dioic acid you can write, so that you can do it by yourself. Then next one, that is from the 11th, what is given, that structure I will be doing it in the next video. Okay, so till then you can practice this, and we will finish it in the next video, the remaining part, and also we'll study about the structure of carboxylic acid. Okay, so we'll stop here. Next time we'll continue with the another part of the video. Okay, thank you very much.